Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, dear brothers and sisters. Welcome to Enlightenment of Deen. In today's video, we will learn another story of Suratul Kahf, which is known as the story of the man with two gardens, or also known as the story of the believer and the disbeliever. When the Quraysh of Makkah became arrogant and proud and were belittling the poor around them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give them the example of the two men. So there were two men, of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave one of them two beautiful gardens of grape wine of various kinds. These were massive and huge gardens that produced its fruits every year and did not have any decrease in its produce. As these gardens were delicate in nature, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also surrounded these gardens with strong date palms to protect them from wind, rainfall, or any such calamity. Each of these gardens produced maximum fruits every year, bringing a lot of profit and money to the owner and never falling short of anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also caused a river to flow between the gardens, so that way there was never shortage of water. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had also blessed him with many other resources besides these grape vines. He was a very rich man who did not have to do anything, as his farms and gardens were taken care of without any effort. One day, while he was having a conversation with his neighbor, he said to him, "I am more greater than you in wealth and much more stronger than you in numbers." He boasted that not only was he rich in money, but also had more noble children than him. He became arrogant and proud of his wealth, and he entered into his gardens saying that his gardens will never perish and will always be fruitful. He also started saying that I don't think that there will be any day of judgment, and even if there will be, he was confident that he will get much more in return than what he had in this world. He considered his gardens to be paradise, and he behaved like those men who were given wealth and power. They misunderstand that they are given the paradise in this world, and they do not stand in need of any other paradise. So his neighbor, who was a believer, said to him, "Do you disbelieve in the one who created you from dust and a drop of liquid and formed you into a man?" By saying this, he wanted to humble down the arrogant man. And the believer also said, "As for myself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone is my Lord, and I will not associate any partners with my Lord." And he told the arrogant man, "When you enter your gardens, why do you not enter with humbleness and humility? And why do you not say, 'Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills will happen, for there is no power except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you find me less than yourself in wealth and children, it may be that my Lord will give me something better than your gardens in the hereafter, and send a calamity upon your gardens from the heavens, and then your gardens will reduce to a waste barren land, and the river that is running between the two gardens may dry and disappear. So why do you feel proud about yourself?" While they were having this conversation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala crushed the rich man's arrogance by completely destroying his gardens, and the man could not do anything about it but started wringing his hands with regret. He stood there watching his most treasured gardens being ruined and not being able to do anything about it nor find any help. That's when he realized what he did and stood there regretting. But it was too late to regret. Let's see the lessons learned from this story. The first thing that we learn is that in the ayahs mentioned in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that it is we who gave him the gardens, the wealth, the fruits, but the man assumed that whatever he had was by his own effort and ability. He forgot that it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who had blessed him with these treasures, and so he grew arrogant and proud of himself. And his arrogance made him belittle his neighbor. So we must always remember that whatever we have is not from our own efforts or abilities, but it is given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, the man thought by being wealthy and rich, he is better than others. However, wealth is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants wealth should always be grateful and thankful to him and should not be arrogant and proud about it. Because it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gives wealth to whomever he wishes, and he is the one who can take it away anytime. Finally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like pride. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "He who has in his heart the weight of a mustard seed of pride shall not enter paradise. That's all for this video. If you find the video informative, please spread the awareness by liking, sharing, and subscribing. Barakallahu feekum.